Hello viewers, I am Jai Pandit. Welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, we will be discussing two transistor analogy of SCR. By the end of this lecture, students will be able to interpret the two transistor analogy of SCR, mathematically prove two transistor analogy of SCR, and relate SCR turn-on techniques with two transistor analogy. We all know that the structure of SCR is a four-layered PNPN type of structure, out of which the top layer is connected to the anode terminal, the bottommost layer is connected to the cathode terminal, and the P layer nearer to the cathode is connected to the gate terminal. There are three different junctions, J1, J2 and J3, formed in the diffusion of the four layers. If we bisect out the middle two layers, that is inner N layer and inner P layer, as shown in the figure, then we will be getting the structure like this. In this structure, we can see we are having two transistors. One is PNP transistor and second one is NPN transistor. Direction of anode current, gate current and cathode current are shown in the figure. Let us separate out these two transistors and see how the structure looks like. So we have separated the two transistors. Junctions will remain same. Junction J1 will be here. Junction J2 will be common for both the transistors, and junction J3 will be here. So according to this, now we are having two transistors connected to each other. One is PNP transistor and another is NPN transistor. If we draw the circuit diagram of this circuit, it will look like, from this circuit diagram we can see and also verify that the base current for the PNP transistor is the collector current for NPN transistor. Here the base current for PNP transistor or transistor Q1 is the collector current for NPN transistor or transistor Q2. And the base current for transistor Q2 will be the summation of gate current and the collector current from transistor Q1. So the base current here, it is the summation of collector current of Q1 and gate current. So moving forward, the common base current gain is given by alpha, and common base leakage current is given by ICBO. So for any transistor, we know that the collector current IC is equal to alpha times IE plus ICBO. So for transistor Q1, using this equation, we can write down IC1 is equal to alpha 1 times IE1 plus ICBO1. 1 is the suffix used for transistor Q1. From the figure, we can see that IE1 is equal to anode current. So let us replace the value of IE1 by anode current. Hence we got IC1 is equal to alpha 1 IA plus ICBO1. Similarly, we can write down for Q2, IC2 is equal to alpha 2 times IE2 plus ICBO2. From figure, again we can say that IE2 is equal to IK or the cathode current. Hence, replacing again IE2 with cathode current, then we will get IC2 is equal to alpha 2 times IK plus ICBO2. Now, these two equations are of importance to us. Let us carry forward these equations to the next slide. Let us see what we get. We have got these two equations of IC1 and IC2 from the earlier slide. Applying KCL at Q1, if we are considering that Q1 is a node in which the entering current is the anode current and the leaving currents are the base current and the collector current. So, if we apply KCL to this node, we will get IA is the entering current and leaving currents are IC1 plus IC2. IC1 plus IC2 or IB1. IB1 is the base current which is leaving from this Q1, but it is same as that of the IC2, that is collector current for transistor Q2. Hence, we can write down IA is equal to IC1 plus IC2. Substitute the values of IC1 and IC2 from these two equations in the equation for IA. We will get IA is equal to alpha 1 times IA plus ICBO1 plus alpha 2 times IK plus ICBO2. If we consider that SCR is a node, then in case of SCR, the entering currents are anode current and gate current, and the leaving current is cathode current. So, according to the KCL, we get cathode current, which is leaving current, is equal to the summation of entering current, that is anode current plus gate current. Hence, IK is equal to IA plus IG. Now, substitute the value of IK from this equation into the upper equation. We get IA is equal to alpha 1 times IA plus ICBO1 plus alpha 2 times. Here we are substituting the value of cathode current, that is anode current plus gate current, plus ICBO2. We have carried forward this same equation from the last slide. If we expand this equation, here we will get IA is equal to alpha 1 times IA plus ICBO1 plus alpha 2 into IA plus alpha 2 into IG plus ICBO2. Here, the common are alpha 1 IA and alpha 2 IA. So, IA, let us take it out common. We will get IA is equal to IA into alpha 1 plus alpha 2 plus alpha 2 times IG. That is from this alpha 2 times IG plus ICBO1 plus ICBO2. If we move this part of the equation to the left hand side, then we will get IA will be common and we are going to get IA into 1 minus alpha 1 plus alpha 2 is equal to alpha 2 times IG plus ICBO1 plus ICBO2. Hence, IA will be equal to alpha 2 times IG plus ICBO1 plus ICBO2 divided by 1 minus alpha 1 plus alpha 2. So this is the equation that we are going to use for proving the two transistor analogy. Now, what we want to prove is, whenever we are supplying a gate current at that particular instant, the anode to cathode current will start flowing. This we want to prove. That means we want to prove that anode current will reach infinite value after supplying of gate current. Or if we are thinking about any other turn-on technique, then we are going to relate that turn-on technique with this same equation, and we are trying to prove that anode current reaches infinite value. That means the SCR turns on. So when we can say that the anode current is going to get infinite value, that will be possible when the sum of alpha 1 and alpha 2 tends to become unity. If alpha 1 and alpha 2 becomes equal to unity, that is 1, then the denominator of this equation will be equal to 0, and we already know that anything divided by 0 is equal to infinite. Hence, if alpha 1 and alpha 2 tend to become unity, then I will become infinite. This will result in turning on of SCR. Under forward biased condition, when we have not given any gate signal or we are not using any turn on technique, under that condition, the current carried by the SCR is the leakage current, which is equivalent to the sum of ICBO1 and ICBO2, which is very small, and it is not sufficient enough to turn on the SCR or latch the SCR into the on state, as the values are very low as compared to that of the latching current. Also, from the transistor theory, we know that the value of alpha increases with the increase in emitter current. Let us see the variation in the values of alpha with variation in emitter current. Here we can see, if the value of IE increases, then the value of alpha tends to become unity. If by some means the emitter current of two transistors can be increased so that alpha 1 and alpha 2 approaches unity, then as per this equation of anode current, we can prove that the SCR is turned on. In our last video, we have seen the turn on techniques of SCR. The turn on techniques of SCR are forward voltage triggering, gate triggering, dV by dt triggering, thermal triggering, and light triggering. In this video, we are going to prove that all these methods are way of increasing the current gain, that is alpha. So let us start one by one with the turn-on techniques and start relating these turn-on techniques with increasing the value of alpha. So let us try to relate forward voltage triggering with that of two transistor analogy. We know that if we increase the forward voltage across the SCR, then the leakage current through the reverse bias junction J2 of the SCR will increase. From the earlier slides, we have already seen that the current through junction J2 is nothing but the collector currents of both transistors Q1 and Q2. If this collector current increases under forward voltage triggering condition, we are not giving any gate current. So our gate current would not be present. Whatever is the collector current of transistor Q1 is the base current for transistor Q2. And for collector current of Q2, it is clear that the collector current of Q2 is the base current for Q1. So if the collector currents IC1 and IC2 are increasing, eventually the base currents of transistor Q1 and Q2 will also increase. We know the relation between the base current and the collector current, that is, the collector current IC is equal to beta times IB. Beta is the current gain. Then if base current increases, collector current further increases. In this way, if we go on increasing the forward voltage, an avalanche process will start, which will increase the collector current, and collector currents will increase the base current. In turn, the base current will again increase the collector current. Due to this avalanche effect, the emitter current of both the transistors will increase, and due to increase in the emitter current, the alpha 1 and alpha 2 of both the transistor will tend to unity. Thus, at last, the SCR will be turned on. So, gate triggering. In case of gate triggering, again we are going to use the same equation. Now, let us come to the circuit. Here, we can see that when gate current is supplied, that gate current acts as the base current to the transistor Q2. If base current of the transistor Q2 is increased, then the collector current of transistor Q2 will eventually increase, as we know that IC2 is equal to beta times IB2. But we also know that the IC2, that is the collector current of transistor Q2, is the base current for transistor Q1. If IC2 increases, eventually IB1 will also increase because they are both the same currents. If base current for transistor Q1 is increased, then eventually the collector current for transistor Q1 will also increase because IC1 is equal to beta times IB1. Now, this collector current will add up with the gate current and will be supplied to the transistor Q2 as the base current. Hence, the base current of transistor Q2 will further increase, which will lead in increasing of the collector current, and this same avalanche process will go on continuing. Because of this avalanche process, the emitter currents of both the transistors Q1 and Q2 will increase. Because of increasing both emitter currents, the values of alpha 1 and alpha 2 will increase, and eventually the SCR will turn on. dV by dt triggering. In dV by dt triggering, we know that the junction J2, which is reverse bias, is considered as a capacitor with capacitance Cj. If the rate of rise of voltage across the SCR is very high, then the current would be set up through this junction J2, which is the capacitor current. This capacitor current is given by IC equal to Cj into dV by dt, where dV by dt is the rate of change of voltage across the junction capacitance. But In the earlier slides, we have also seen that the current through junction J2 is the combination of collector current of transistor Q1 and transistor Q2. Hence, if the current through junction J2 increases, then collector currents of both the transistor will increase. And in earlier slides, we have also seen that if these collector currents increase, these collector currents will increase the base current, and base currents will eventually increase the collector currents. This avalanche process will again happen, and the emitter currents of both transistor would increase, which will lead to increase of the alpha 1 and alpha 2 values, and the transistor will turn on. Thermal triggering. In case of thermal triggering, as the temperature of junction J2 increases, the leakage current across junction J2 also increases. The current across junction J2 is the collector current for transistors Q1 and Q2. Increase in the value of collector currents of both the transistor will lead to an avalanche process which increases the value of emitter currents of both transistors, thus increasing the values of alpha 1 and alpha 2. If alpha 1 and alpha 2 increases, from this equation we can see that the denominator will tend to 0 and overall value of anode current will tend to infinity. Thus, SCR will turn on. Light triggering. When light is imparted on the silicon wafer, then photons from the light will release energy and electron hole pairs are generated. As more number of free charge carriers, that is electrons and holes, are now available, the leakage current across the junction J2 increases. As the leakage current increases, the collector currents of both the transistor will also increase, because the current across junction J2 comprises of the collector currents of both the transistors. Thus, again, because of the avalanche process, collector currents will increase the base currents will again increase the collector currents. Due to this, eventually the emitter currents of both the transistors will increase. Due to increase in the emitter currents, values of alpha 1 and alpha 2 will increase, and sum of alpha 1 and alpha 2 will tend to unity, thus increasing the value of anode current to infinite. In this way, the SCR turns on by light triggering. So, in this discussion, we have seen the two transistor analogy of SCR, which included the circuit of SCR represented as a two transistors or as a combination of two transistors. Then we have seen the relation between all the turn on techniques of SCR with the two transistor analogy. These are some references which we have used for preparing this presentation. If you like this video, please hit the like button. Please do subscribe our channel for more updates. Thank you.